If I were to show you a list of all the anime I've watched, two things would become very apparent. One, I'm a shonen junkie, and two, I don't really watch much isekai. I'm not quite sure why. It's not that the form of storytelling itself doesn't interest me, because I do like the concept of being transported into another world and having to fight your way out of it, or being completely reborn and having the ability to be a completely different person. Though, I do have an idea as to why I'm not attracted to isekai series, which is in large part due to the stint of time where I had recently moved to a new country and had other things besides anime and manga on my mind. And because of this time away from two of my favorite mediums, I missed out on a lot of the more popular isekai series like Konosuba, Overlord, and ReZero, which I haven't watched but am planning to. But it wasn't just anime that I missed out on. I missed out on a bunch of other things like video games and never got the chance or interest to explore MMORPGs, which a lot of isekai series use as a base for their world. So, when I see, let's take Kirito, devote so much time to a game to the point where he's a beta tester and has an advantage over everybody else, I just can't relate to that. Although I know it happens, I do pour hours into games, just not these types, and I do have friends who do play MMORPGs and pour hours into a game. But me, I don't know what it's like to indulge myself entirely into this completely different world for hours on end just to hone my sword skills, increase my damage output, or raid a dungeon. Which is why I was quite reluctant on making videos on this series due to how uninformed I am, and how a large part of my interest on this series was garnered due to its massive popularity and a bit off what people told me about it. I'm just being honest. So I decided to make a first impressions video to see if you liked the way I discussed this series or not, and whether I should continue doing them. But oddly enough, my sort of inexperience with these types of games and series actually put me in a place where I can somewhat relate to our main character. Our main character, Iwatani Naofumi, is somewhat estranged to this world he's brought into, well, at least compared to all the other hotshot gamers. Said difference of experience is noticeable right off the bat with how differently the other three heroes handle being summoned, and even throughout the episode, their entire demeanor and way of viewing things are different compared to how Naofumi views and perceives things. And if I'm being honest, this was enough to keep me interested for the first half of the episode, experiencing and learning about things like how this world and the shield work at the same time Naofumi is, really kept me engaged and wanting to learn more. And then we get to the second half of the episode, which includes the oh-so-controversial twist, where we see everything that has so carefully been stacked up against Naofumi completely tumble over him. Naofumi's inexperience, the fact that he's wielding a shield but is no Captain America, leave him partyless, unable to explore the outside world and essentially level up. That is, up until this thot offers herself up as tribute. Mine had me fooled. She seemed like a good person, and it seemed like she had genuinely good intentions. But then I remembered the opening sequence, where we see this person, who is supposed to be the same person we see not even a minute later, but something is obviously very different apart from the fact that mine is nowhere to be seen. But regardless, the episode keeps going, and we see more and more of Naofumi, and at the same time see how excited he is to be a part of all of this. But the expression on the face of the man in the beginning of the episode is very different to the one Naofumi carries throughout it. That is, until mine accuses Naofumi of attempting to rape her. which not only leads to IRL controversy, but also leads to everybody believing Mind and now Fumi not having a chance to defend himself and being stripped of everything. Still a hero, yes, but by technicality and not desire. Mind took everything from Naofumi, his clothes, his money, his dignity, but most importantly, a chance at reinventing himself. And the fact that a lot of isekai series have that concept of reinvention as their core speaks volumes as to how big of a deal this is. I'm a sucker for a well-told revenge story, and I can't wait to keep on watching Naofumi, the decisions he makes, and hopefully that time he gets the revenge he longs for. Because to me, it seems like Naofumi is still reinventing himself, it's just in a much, much different way than he initially expected. But hey, these are my thoughts, and I'm curious to read what you have to say about this episode. So talk about what you liked, what you didn't like, and what you got from this episode. And if you're a manga reader / light novel reader, let me know how you feel about the adaptation while keeping your comments spoiler free. I appreciate all comments, so feel free to leave one, whether you answer any of the questions I asked or start a discussion on anything you deem worthy of discussing, whether it be related to the episode or anything I said, and I'll reply whenever I can. Please like the video if you enjoyed it, feel free to follow me on Twitter for updates, or if you just want to interact with me. And yo, there's this chance that if you're watching this video right now, you're not yet subscribed to the channel, so here's what you're gonna do. Create an account if you haven't already, and after that you're going to click on the big red subscribe button as well as the bell. That way you don't miss a video and can keep on watching the Rising of the Shield Hero as well as many other series with me. And with that being said, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you guys soon. Peace.